Welcome to the Decimal Chain channel. This video comes the first in the series dedicated to the tokenization of business and the introduction of the Decimal Chain blockchain into business processes. There are many options for working with blockchain, and I will be pleased to see your comments below. There you can also give recommendations regarding the topic of the next videos, as well as ask any questions. In this video, I want to analyze the implementation of blockchain in the system of time tracking and control of employee actions. It's relevant primarily to those who have a large number of staff or require protection of fixing the actions of your subordinates. So, the easiest way to fix data in the decimal chain blockchain is to use comments to transactions, since they cannot be changed and they are kept in the distributed ledger forever. And I believe you also know that one of blockchain benefits is about its transparency and openness. And this enables any user to log into the browser and see people's comments left in the transaction. Therefore, the logical conclusion, if you do not want to make your records open, you need to encrypt your comments by a reliable system that wouldn't be decrypted. Instead of this, brute force technology can be used. I choose the secure hash algorithm. Thus, CHA256 is one of the most popular and often used hashing algorithms. You can use ready-made online and software services, but I think you agree that it would be easier for business if processes could be automated, and it's better to hire a specialist to program these actions. Moreover, a good programmer is what we need next. As a result, any text will turn into 64 symbols that should be kept in the transaction comments. This hash would serve as a proof that text hasn't been changed. After all, in case of adjustments to any symbol, you would know that the data is fake. Now, let us turn back to our case. To record the time of arrival and departure of an employee, it is necessary to have a database where the information is recorded and the device itself or the fixation program, and in addition, the presence of two wallets created in decimal chain between which transactions will be created. Now, for more details. The database has a tabular display and can even be represented as an Excel table. For accounting, we need data, such as the user ID, the time of fixation, the label entered or logged out. This data is reduced to a single record format and encrypted. The resultant hash is recorded in a table, and to protect the stored data, it can be immediately sent to the blockchain, leaving a comment with the hash to the created transaction between their wallets. In addition, at the end of the working day, when there is already an array of data, they can also be combined and encrypted. For example, you can safely glue the hash of the arrival and departure of an employee while receiving the hash of the employee's shift. A fixation device is a way of recording time-bound data. It's very important to get the data discussed above from the user. It can be an electronic pass reading system, or QR or barcode scanning, or even a manual recording method, but it is not safe because of the understandable human factor when mistakes can be made. The main task of such a system is to record the time and record the user's data with the labels we need, in this case, departure or arrival. Now, when we have the necessary data, it needs to be encrypted and recorded into the blockchain with the frequency you need. To do this, program transactions with a hash in a comment and configure, together with the programmer, a visual display of the database, which, before opening the necessary information, accesses the blockchain and compares the hash recorded in the blockchain and the one in your database. If it matches, then the data has not changed and they can be trusted. Next, if necessary, configure the access system to your database via login and password. You can also record them in your database and write their hash to the blockchain. As you can see, there are many variations of practical application. After all, instead of the text came and went, there may be others, for example, as you have already understood, logged in, added, deleted or edited information, or even left for lunch or made a call. The main thing here is to grasp the essence in order to understand the logic of creating a secure accounting system, and at least write a clear technical task for a programmer, or contact the Decimal team for help in implementing it into your business, if your project is ready to interact with the blockchain and you understand what you want to get. In addition, take care of where the main accounting table will be stored, on one computer and a USB flash drive, or it will be a distributed storage system on multiple devices, as in the blockchain. And with this, I think the case is solved, and I hope it became clearer to you how to use one of the features of DecimalChain. Wish you a successful experience of working with blockchain. See you later in our next videos.